Hi, we're Nick and Valerie Wisniewski on behalf of expertvillage.com. We'd like to talk to you about bobcat trails, and for more information, you can check out our website, www.walnuthilltracking.com. Bobcat is a seldom seen member of the wildcat family that we have here in the Northeast and throughout North America. And the bobcat shows four toes in its tracks, very rarely shows claws because it has retractable claws. The bobcat has a fairly robust heel pad, and in between the heel pad and the toes is a C shape. That's one of the distinguishing features of a bobcat track. Another thing that you look for in a bobcat track is asymmetry of the toes and the heel pad. Sometimes it looks almost like the toes and the heel pad are pointing in different directions. Other features to look for are at the leading edge of the heel pad is a bilobe, and on the trailing edge is a trilobe. In other words, three lobes in back and two lobes in front. Other animals like wild dogs do not have that feature. The bobcat is a very efficient mover, and when it's moving around the landscape, it prefers to move in a walk. Oftentimes it will move in a direct register walk like we're trying to show here, where a hind foot lands on top of a front foot. And a bobcat, when it's walking, has an extremely variable stride that it can do. It can go anywhere from about 11 and a quarter inches to 25 or 26 inches, but on average it's going to be somewhere around 14 and a half to 16 and a half inches in between these steps on the ground. The trail tends to be wide, which is a distinguishing feature. And if we look at the trail width of this particular example that we've laid out here, it should be fairly typical, about 4.5 inches almost, a little over 4 inches. And again, that's going to be variable. On a bobcat, it could be anywhere from 3 inches to 5 3/8 or so wide. But the general impression when you look at the trail is that it's wide for the distance that it's covering.